Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you cannot tell from the title, today's video is essentially gonna be on how I maintain my butterfly locks and also just how I feel about butterfly locks in general and my recommendation on if you should finally get them. So if you want to see what I have to say, definitely stay tuned. But first, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, turn on your notifications, and go follow me on IG and TikTok. Alright guys, so these are my butterfly locks, and so typically I just kind of, you know, wear them like this. That's pretty much it. I just try to like keep my hands out of them, and then sometimes I'll just put a bobby pin here to, you know, keep them in place. But I do need to moisturize them, and so I did want to come and show you all how I moisturize them. And so the first product that I'll be going in with is this spray right here, and this is for my scalp, and this is the African Pride Olive Miracle Anti-Breakage Formula, and it's for tension relief and shine, and it's a braid sheen spray. So this is what it looks like. And so in the past, there was a very popular one I think that I grew up using, but that actually dried my scalp out a little bit more. So I do like African Pride products. You can purchase these at Family Dollar. And I do like the spray actually. So it actually does relieve itchiness, you know, if your scalp gets itchy throughout the process. So first I do like to go in with this. And I don't, of course, spray the hair because my real hair is tucked away inside the twist, you know, so it's pointless to saturate the synthetic hair. So I just make sure to go in and get my scalp. And so I do this probably 3 to 4 times a week. So I just go in and make sure I get my scalp. And then I just like to kind of just rub my scalp to make sure, you know, that I can kind of press the product in and it's not just kind of like sitting there, even though, you know, it will absorb. But I just like to do that because I will be going in with an oil on my scalp as well. So my oil of choice is gonna be the Wild Growth hair oil. And if you're not familiar with this, then it's just a really popular oil. So I've been using it for years. I actually think, you know, it helps my hair be healthy. I'm just making sure to stay on the scalp and not to, you know, be too messy with the product and not to let it, you know, run. If you're familiar, this oil, when it runs, it can kind of get everywhere, but it's not necessarily watery. It's actually kind of has like a decent consistency, but I just like to make sure it's not going to be running down my neck. Usually I do this before I get in the shower, you know, so any excess oil I can kind of wipe away. And if you only want to use one hair oil, that's fine. You can place this on your edges as well. But on my edges and my nape, I like to go in with Jamaican Black Castor Oil. So I am using the one by Creole Essence, and it's 100% pure Haitian Black Castor Oil, and original. And I purchased this from Ulta. So I'm gonna go in my nape area and my edges, essentially my perimeter, with this specifically. So I'm just taking my little dropper. This is mostly gone. I probably have maybe about 25% of the bottle left. So I'm just gonna go in here on my edges. And being sure to just only focus on your scalp, it'll also just keep the hair from being like so greasy, you know, when you touch it. You all know, we've been there, done that, put oil, you know, especially with box braids, on the shaft of the braid, so we can make sure we get all of our hair that's exposed, and it can just kind of make the braids really greasy and oily, and it just kind of transfers everywhere. All right, so next I'm gonna go in with this Cantu avocado hydrating curling cream with shea butter, mango butter, and coconut oil. So I'm just gonna put some of this in my hands and rub it along my edges. I do that because I just want to protect my edges as much as possible, of course, because just like any, you know, gel or holding product, I think, you know, with continued use, eventually, you know, it'll do the same thing as the other products, just maybe in a slower fashion. So I just like to take a dime size amount, rub it in my hands, and then just focus it on my edges like this. And then I just have my little edge brush, and I'm just gonna kind of brush that product in a little bit. Now my edges are nice and soft and hydrated. And throughout this hairstyle, I've had this hairstyle going on 3 weeks now, and I hate when there's like, you know, constant buildup on the edges from putting, you know, a lot of edge control on daily. And so I find that if I want my style to last longer, then I'm only apply a little bit. So since this is like the last week I'm gonna have the hairstyle up, then I can kind of OD, you know, a little bit with my edge control if I want to. And so, like I said, since I'm going into my third week, I am gonna just put a little bit more than I usually would, and then I'm gonna tie my hair up. So now I'm just gonna take my edge control brush and just brush everything backwards. So last but not least, I'm going to go in with the Nairobi Foaming Lotion. I'm just going to put this everywhere and focus on the front. So I'm just rubbing this in for now. So I'm just going to go in here. Then I just put some in my hand, and I'm going to go over the shaft of the hair. All right, so now I'm just gonna take my headscarf and tie it around and just have the hair fall back. So now I'm just gonna let this sit. I'm gonna do my makeup, and I'll show y'all the end result. All right, guys, so I'm back. My makeup is done and I am dressed. So this is just my hair, nothing crazy. Literally, it was just in a messy bun because I'm making other videos as well. And I just kind of let it fall how it fell. So this is just how I'll be wearing my hair today. I think it's really cute, but I'm gonna zoom y'all in just so y'all can see my edges. It's nothing crazy, it's not super late. I just wanna make sure my hair is moisturized. So close up, as you can see, this is just my hair. Everything is just like a little flattened out. And so, like I stated previously, you know, there's not really gonna be any product buildup or anything like that. So I just prefer this. I also think it helps the hairstyle last a little bit longer versus, you know, putting jam on it every day and getting that buildup. And then also, you know, when you go in to wash your hair, right, you have to focus on those areas to make sure you get all that product out. And so, you know, we're focusing on the edges this year. We're focusing on healthy hair and healthy skin. And so that's essentially how, you know, I moisturize my hair. And so make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, turn on your posts and notifications, so you know when I upload. Go follow me on IG as well as TikTok, and then meet me back here because I will be posting more videos. I have a lot of hauls coming up that I'll probably be filming today as well, so make sure you stay tuned, and I'll see y'all on the next one. Bye, guys.